The next speaker, Arif Amir Rahman Stiwan from Japan. I hope that I pronounce your name correctly. Your work is around prospective LCA-based energy evaluation of pulp production from EFB. If you are ready, the floor or the screen is yours. Arif Amir, you are around.
Yes, hello. Can we keep being here?
Would you please, would you please share your screen?
Yes, okay. Can it be seen?
I think it will be coming. Perfect.
You now see yes. My screen?
Okay. Great. You put it in full screen, please. Yes. Oh, great. Go ahead.
Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good evening from here. It's my pleasure to be here. Thank you very much for conducting this interesting event. I got many knowledge from here. My name is Arif Amir Rahman Setiawan. I'm a PhD student in the University of Tokyo. Now I'm still conducting distance learning because I cannot enter Japan at the moment. So the title of our study is Prospective LCA-based Energy Evaluation for Pulp Production from Tea Fruit Plants. For that, I will close my video because the connection sometimes get low. And okay, so thank you. So in here, I'm the second author. The first author is actually Dr. Agusta Samudra.
There's a little bit noise. Excuse me to interrupt you. There is a little bit noise. If you can.
Yes, excuse me.
Okay, go ahead. It's not technical problem. I think it's technical problem. Go ahead.
Okay. And the first author is actually Agusta Samudra Putrai. He has just graduated from the University of Tsukuba, so I'm represent him to present this study. So the background of our study is actually based on the current situation, which is the pulp demand across the globe are expected to recover and will increase soon after the pandemic. So particularly the sustainability of the paper for the now, the growth is basically due to the utilization for hygiene papers, food-based packaging, corrugated packaging materials, medical specialty paper, and so on. Supported with the rise in demand, the production of pulp is expected to grow more in the future. This is according to Bloomberg. And we know that pulp and paper is also known for its energy-intensive industry, and it has impact on global warming, such as accounted for 10% of deforestation, and also contribute around the deforestation is contribute about 12% of global warming. Therefore, the challenge is to provide supply for the production while also considering the environmental impact. Now, the raw material supply for from pulpwood, especially is depleting in some countries. We can read such as in China, because the availability of forest is decreasing. Well, so in some other country, we also in Indonesia, including facing the issue related to deforestation. Therefore, it is challenging to find alternative source for supplying the Brother Sian suggests from non-wadi biomass. In Indonesia, particularly, generated around 43.5 million ton of different plants per year. Therefore, from here, it has potential source for pulp production. In the meanwhile, we also consider the method to assess and to evaluate the sustainability of product. In this case, among the most common method is life cycle assessment. There are also increasing interest to use energy analysis. So this is the in this figure, you can see the proportion of contribution of pulp, paper pulp and print toward the greenhouse gas emission. And in the figure below, we can see that Indonesia is among the producer with highest capacity of production for about 20 years. So we in this table, we can see the alternative source of biomass, which has potential for pulp production by considering the content such as the cellulose, which is based on various study. And in the next slide, we can see the oil palm plantation in Indonesia, and including the empty fruit plants from milling production, mostly concentrated in the Sumatra Island and in the Kalimantan Island. And this is the production of oil palm from plantation until we got the fresh fruit plant, then process it into mill, and it generate the the residue empty fruit plants. So the question is how we can also add value to these empty fruit plants. Now, the methodology used in this study, we adopt the method from the life cycle assessment. So the method in the life cycle assessment consists of four main methods, such as from Kulen scope, then inventory analysis, impact assessment, and interpretation. In this study, we extend the inventory analysis by introducing MRV analysis using some of the formula. So what is MRV analysis? If we see some literatures such in the Scopus, there is increasing study on the MRV analysis. So the MRV analysis in general can be described as the quantitative analysis that evaluate resources, goods, or service in common unit of solar energy. So the reference is solar energy and measured as solar energy joule. So this term coined firstly by Odum. Further, if we see what is the difference of energy, exergy, and emergy. So basically, the energy is only answering the question concerning the size of energy flow in the process. It doesn't consider the quality, while exergy is also consider the quantity and also the quality. The both of this is a thermodynamic. With the unit is joules, while MRV analysis is based on the how much solar energy has been used to create source of the flow. The more solar energy used, it means that the higher transformity in the MRV flow. If we trace back some of potential utilization of empty fruit plants, there are a number of utilization, including to produce a pulp production. This is the example of previous study with analysis and the potential reactive for pulp profession, including the previous presentation. So the role of prospective LCA in MRT analysis. So we separate the definition of LCA and MRT analysis, and there is also some effort to combine both approach. For example, study by CAM in 2016 tried to use the environmental sustainability assessment based on LCA and MRT analysis. And this is also followed by Oliveira, published in this year. This also tried to combine LCA and MRT analysis. So what is the position of this study? So we compare both case of wood-based pulp production and empty fruit plant-based pulp. And wood-based pulp, there are a number of study for evaluating the assessment by conducting LCA, also conducting emergy such as by Porcelain, and also try to combine in LCA and MRV analysis last year by Santa Teta. While study on LCA on AFP based pulp has also been conducted such as by Putra. However, study by combining LCA and MRV analysis has not been found yet. Therefore, we try to fill this gap by conducting this research. Now we move on the result and discussion after the methods. So this is the MRT analysis diagram we used for wood pulp production. So basically what we require is like LC analysis, it's inventory, flow diagram and inventory. So this is the wood-based pulp production, the current scenario, which need some, in general, needs input such as fossil fuel, fertilizer, and rain, sun. Rain and sun is input especially for MRV analysis. So they consider the input in term of sun and rain. There are also input of electricity for the production, also input of chemicals to generate the pulp. While this diagram is for EFP pulp production, so in this framework, we add one more process. It is CPO production in addition of the previous scenario. And there are also a number of input and output also. And we have more output in here, that is crude palm oil. So then in the next slide, you can see in the number of input and output for both wood pulp production and also empty fruit plants pulp production. So this inventory is input and output is basically in the foreground process, while the background process, we take the inventory from database of EcoInvent. So for example, in here, to produce 1 meter cubic of pulpwood, we need input such as carbon dioxide in the air, wood, and also energy input such as diesel. Also need a surface input. And this is the inventory analysis of oil palm production for generating fresh fruit plants. This is also taken from the EcoInvent database. And now we can compare the MRV analysis for the wood palm production and also empty fruit plants based palm production. And this is the parameters used in MRV analysis, and the final calculation is the MRV sustainability index, where the higher the index mean that the more sustainable. In this case, we calculate that the multi-fruit bench is more sustainable for pulp production. So this is the interpretation from the parameter. For example, the transformability of wood pulp is higher than multi-fruit bench, means that energy flow of wood pulp is higher, then therefore wood pulp need more energy, while ELR wood pulp is more higher than multi-fruit bench pulp. Due to the plantation, would mean wood pulp need more renewable energy such as fertilizer. So in the term of energy analysis, the theory is to classify whether the input or output is renewable or not, and where the sun is considered as renewable. While the parameter of PSI of the EFP pulp is higher than wood pulp, meaning that the process is more sustainable. However, we also found that the process such as agricultural practice and chemical input were taken generic data from the database, which is it can be explored further for more comprehensive calculation. As for the conclusion, in the study, the sustainability of pulp production was calculated based on ASI, Energy Sustainability Index. Flow calculation can be integrated with the life cycle inventory analysis as we have been performed in the study. The sustainability of EFP-based pulp production is higher than wood pulp production according to the ASI value. And finally, the MRK evaluation in the field of wood pulp with utilization still has large space for improvement. This is the end of my presentation. Thank you for listening, and question will be welcome. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ali, for this brilliant presentation. And once again, your work showed the usefulness of all palm components. Empty fruit branch have a great potential. Every part of this biomass, this interest in biomass have an interest in valorization in our daily life. Very well done, LCA analysis. I congratulate you and all the team for this outcome. And I leave the floor asking a question. If there are any question, please, you can just raise your hand or type your question in the bar chat. Is there any question? Yeah, if there is no questions, I will just ask you about an important parameters that we should define on LCA, the functional units. I didn't see the functional unit in your presentation. Can you define it? Functional units of your LCA analysis, because you compared two things.
Yes, yes. Okay, thank you, Prof. Laila, for the question. So actually, if in the context of functional unit, we conduct, because it combined with the MRK analysis, in the MRK analysis, we didn't have unit. Yeah. But the functional unit for this case, we use per 1 kilogram of pulp for either for EFP or for wood-based pulp. And after we converted it into MRK calculation, and in this MRK we didn't use unit.
Okay, and how about the sensitivity analysis? Did you conduct this final part of LC analysis?
For now, we don't conduct. We have not conducted the sensitivity analysis. Actually, for LCA, we can conduct it for next study, as for example, by changing one of parameter or using the different methods, yeah, for example, CML or recipes like that.
Okay, so it will be maybe for yeah. next by Palma.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
By Palma and
interesting.
In
case, yeah. Thank you.
In this case, we will enjoy your work if it's from cradle to grave, not from cradle yes. to gate. Okay.
Okay. I will talk to my professor so that he can allow me and send me to attend this for next.
Professor year. Ramsey, you heard that? You are
sure. I am agree with you.
To conduct more full LC analysis in the next edition, maybe. Thank you, yes. Dr. Ari, for your brilliant presentation and.